を知ることは取り返しがつかない。言ってる意味わかる？
与
えられたものは忘れてから思い出すことはできるけれど、また知ることはもうできます。これも思い出した？それとも初めて知った？私はまだ何も知らないけれど、あなたの知っていることがあなたのメモリ
ー。イルクライトのことを
知っている、もしくは
虚無への
一生のことを知
っている
。高話は良くないね。もう知っていることかもしれないし、
I kept staring at the waves, but left before long. I walked away from the seashore until I reached the staircase. First, I arrived at the riverside. The water from this river would eventually reach the sea. Somehow, I was more concerned with the secrets than I was. At this riverside, I somehow arrived at, though I was surely descending the staircase.
I lingered
for about 3 minutes. I had already opened one of the books, Finnegan's Wake, written by James Joyce, 1939, new,
The book is filled with perfect commands of wordplay and coined words, and the story, which is found among them, develops around a couple, H.C. and A.L.P. I open the book from the back and see the last scene. As A.L.P. throws herself into the river, the following sentence ends with the word "the." It implies that there is a noun that follows after. I threw Finnegan's wake far down the river. It flattered in midair and fell into the water. I returned where I had been before and found the Finnegan's wake, just as before, dry without a single drop of water on it. The book that I pick up from the surface of the river is completely dry, as if it is new. It was as if it was kept in the same condition, and it did not change very much after I picked it up, from which it seemed to be followed by a reflecting light floating in the streams of the morning mist. It did not change. Finnegan's Wake, written by James Joyce, 1939, new. The book is filled with a perfect command of wordplay and coined words. I open the book, and it begins with Finnegan, a carpenter, falling from a roof and dying. But he comes back to life during his wake. Where did it come from? I threw Finnegan's wake far away from the river. It flattered in midair and fell into the water. The first word of Finnegan's Wake is a lowercase river run. The story begins as if it suddenly fell from or into a river. I followed the river downstream as it carried the book. I kept following the river. I kept following the river. I had already opened one of the books, The Boy Who Fell Over Niagara Falls, written by Bastien Ade. The book was used for his reading performance in 1972. The story is based on an actual accidental fall which took place in the Niagara Falls. And after he finished reading, Ada left the room as he wiped his tears. I found a book about to be swallowed by the waterfall. I stopped descending the stairs to pick it up, and I was at the waterfall and no longer descending the stairs. But somehow the book was dry, as if it were brand new. I go around the bank, careful that the boat does not follow the waterfall. It was as if it was kept in the same condition, and it did not change very much after I picked it up. The Boy Who Fell Over Niagara Falls, written by Bastien Ade. The book was used for his reading performance in 1972. The story tells of a boy being miraculously saved after falling into the Niagara Falls. Ade was an artist who persisted in falling throughout his life, sometimes from a roof, sometimes from the riverside. He would fall. Did he ever think to fall from a waterfall?
threw myself into the water, swallowed by a rushing stream. I was carried over the falls by the snow and the water. Help did not arrive. Help did not arrive. I find that I have been walking along the river. My thoughts are confused, and it's because of my dictation. There is a thick morning mist. I have a slight, yet sure premonition that I will arrive at Riverside. For some reason, I was already crying. My thoughts are confused, and it is because of my dictation. The morning mist thickens. But I arrive at the staircase, or a waterfall. If I know that it is a staircase, it looks like a staircase. But if I cease to believe so, or suspect that it is something else, it immediately seems only to be a waterfall. After some time, I was gradually unable to see it as a staircase. I had already opened one of the books. Or rather, I realized that I had been staring at the waterfall with the book in my hand all along. No. Or I had already opened a magazine article, The Final Poem, written by John Watson, 1893. It is a report of the incident where Mr. Sherlock Holmes, who Dr. Watson had long acted as an assistant, and his rival died in each other's hand. According to the report, Mr. Holmes was brought to the waterfall by his rival, where, as a result of a one-on-one duel, fell together into the waterfall. Their bodies had not been discovered. As I read the report, I recalled Mr. Bastian Allen, the artist who sailed into sea, never to return. I must have picked up this book from the waterfall. The book was completely dry, as if it were brand new. It was as if it was kept in the same condition. And even after I picked up the book, which floated in the streams of the morning mist, followed by the effect of light, it did not change very much. Impatient, I threw the book far away. The book flattered in midair and fell onto the staircase. It fell a few steps more from where it hit the ground, and many of the pages were badly bent. On second look, the book is soaking wet, so much that it made a small puddle on the stairs. Then I just stared at the dripping water without ascending or descending the staircase. I just stared at the dripping water. I just stared at the waterfall. I just stared at the waterfall. The waterfall was far from where I was speaking, and about halfway lay the nude body of a woman. In her stretched left arm, she held a gas lamp. I stepped away from the people and rubbed my eyes. My eyes twitched with from staring without blinking. I heard that Posthumus by Mr. Marcel Duchamp, who had recently passed away, was installed in this wall, so I could come to see. I looked again through the hole on the half-torn wooden wall. I just stared at the waterfall. The waterfall was far from where I was speaking, and about halfway lay the nude body of a woman. In her stretched left arm, she held a scarf. I recall Mr. Duchamp's profile from his later years. His half-bald head and long, hooked nose resembled that of Mr. Holmes that I had once seen in the museum. I'm staring at the nude body of a woman. She is extremely excited, perhaps due to the drug, and is having intercourse with a man. I had already known that the man, the book, so rich, was having to work kept in that condition all along. And even after I picked it up, it did not change very much. Blue, written by Naoki Yamamoto, 1991. An anthology by a comic artist skilled in sexual expression. What are you? I felt like throwing myself, Mrs. Fall. Yeah, show me. Forget it. Impatient, I threw myself into the waterfall. Then I returned to where I was before, this time to find a book with a blue cover, though dry, with dent marks all over. I have been descending the staircase for a long time, but I was yet to reach downstairs. It is spring outside. I did not know why I was concerned with the water. Anyway, the fact that the food is still living inside me, from the living fact itself, tortured me in the fear of falling from the staircase. The antidote is downstairs. If I were to fall from the stairs, it was too late when I realized. I even thought, oh no, not me. I slipped on a wet step on the stairs. My concern about water a while back was a premonition. I noticed that there were only about 10 steps left to the floor. And as I fell, I caught sight of a small armchair resting on that floor. Someone was sitting on the armchair. A figure arrives from behind and sits nearby. They chat for some time, and the figure takes out a syringe and injects it into the person sat in the armchair. This will be my last dictation before darkness. What did I fall for? What did I fail to write? Or what should have I failed to write?
was awakened by a pain in my back from hitting the leg of the armchair. Which means I did not wake up someplace without an armchair. The armchair is there from the beginning. I cannot begin this dictation from nothing. The pain does not get better. It feels like nothing will change. Well, I remember. I'm descending the stairs, though I do not recall for how long. It is most likely that I've been descending all along. I must descend the staircase, heading downstairs to find the antidote. I must be extremely careful about these stairs. I am tortured with the fear of falling any moment now. Let me explain the poison I was injected with. I found a slight syringe mark on my left arm. The mark is from an injection of a poison. The poison's qualities will make one fall eventually. Fall where? From where? That is not within the qualities of the poison. The poison is just a poison that makes you fall. Luckily, the poison is slow acting. I did not begin falling the moment it was injected. But the fact that the poison is still dwelling inside me, or the dwelling fact itself, tortured me with the fear of falling from the staircase. The antidote is downstairs. If I were to end up falling on my way downstairs to get the antidote, that is only ironic. All that I have just stated is true, but why I know of all these things, I do not know.
It was too late when I realized.
But about 10 steps from the ground, I inevitably missed my step, and my body bounces on each step as I tumble over. 9 more steps, 8 steps, 7 steps, 6 steps, 5 steps, 4 steps, 3 steps. I was awakened by a pain in my back from hitting the leg of the armchair, which means I did not wake up someplace without an armchair. The armchair is there from the beginning. I cannot begin this dictation from nothing. The pain does not get better. It feels like it won't change. I stand up, supporting myself with the armchair. I see that the seat is sunk into the shape of my body, like a mold waiting for plaster to be poured into. There is a syringe in the middle of the seat. As far as I can tell from the label, it contains a poison. I am a doctor, and I'm familiar with the poison. The poison's qualities will make one fall eventually. Fall where? From where? That is not within the qualities of the poison. The poison is just a poison that makes you fall. Hidden behind the backrest of the armchair, there is a small staircase. I had noted earlier when I stood up. It is darker below, and nothing is to be seen. But upstairs is the antidote. Upstairs? No, I meant downstairs. I must descend the staircase, heading downstairs to find the antidote. I must be extremely careful about these stairs. I am tortured with the fear of falling any moment now. Any moment now, I will encounter 3 books in a specific order. I know that this is necessary for applying the antidote. The correct procedure. Thank you.
see without the sky above. The sky was wider than what we see with our mind. And since it was daytime, it was a clear blue. Rather, it was a clear blue, so it was daytime. Anyway, I had already opened one of the books. The Foundation of Judah, written by E. The author, who is also an artist, wrote it as a textbook for Judo. Throughout the book, all of the elements of Judo are illustrated with words and
diagrams.
Misui, who is false,
but she feels like a
I opened the book.
もう知っていることかもしれないし。